Hello and welcome. And in this show about science, I squash a bug and some books squash me. Okay, so scientists have long debated the nature of light. Is light a wave or is it a stream of particles? It is important to answer this question to unravel the mysteries of the universe and possibly even fulfill Einstein's dream of riding on a beam of light. Let's try to answer this question. First, consider this water trough. The waves will pass through both slits and interact, adding up in some places and nullifying each other in other places. Let's refer to this as wave behavior. The same experiment, when performed with a beam of light instead of water, gave this result. Alternate light and dark bands, with the central light band being the brightest.
So light is a wave. Problem solved. And not so fast.
Now consider this. Let's refer to this as particle behavior. So if we fire individual electrons at the screen, we should get particle behavior, as individual electrons can't interfere with each other, right? At first, the result seems to be random, but after some time, we get the same wave-like pattern. This is where common sense ends and the rule of quantum laws begins. What is believed to happen here is that while the electron passes through one slit only, its wave of probability, or the wave showing the probable locations of the electron, passes through both the slits, somehow resulting in the electron interfering with itself.
Preposterous!
So why not put a detector in there to see which slit the electrons are going through? This, in fact, gave an even weirder result. Each electron went through only one slit, but now the electrons behave like particles. It is uncanny. Let's try and understand this using some common interpretations. There's the many worlds interpretation, where there are many universes and each universe is created by a decision we take in life. And each universe has a copy of each particle in another universe. Back to the experiment, one world has sent the electron through the left slit, while another has sent it through the right slit. Taking the measurement somehow results in the particle breaking contact with its multiverse copies. Unfortunately, we don't know if other universes exist. So there's no point adding another level of complication till we can prove that. That's why there's the Copenhagen interpretation. Niels Bohr suggested that quantum particles exist in all states, not one, a concept called coherent superposition. By trying to observe and measure it, like in checking which slit the electron went through, we cause this coherent superposition to collapse, much like a house of cards. Turns out light acts both as a wave and a particle. Or none. This is Arhan Goel signing off.